AMR6 by Jack Spero. One of the best seasons so far, this had to be difficult. In this video, we'll show that AMR6 and RMR races like it are a lot easier than you think and even easier to build. If you want Algodoo videos like this, subscribe and click the bell. You'll be there when new videos come out. Oh, didn't see you there. So, have you heard of AMR6? If you've been following Jack Spero recently, you would know he has already posted two parts of it. You would know in his videos that he has really stepped up his scripting game. However, if you wanted to make it, it's a lot less difficult than it looks. In this video, we'll be showing how it works and how you can make it in Algodoo. Let's get to it! So, here's the station I built. This is going to be the entire backbone of the marble race, so I decided to build that first. You can see here I tried to replicate what I saw on Jack Sparrow's channel. Although we have some parts that are really important to this. Mainly these two things. This is what allows the models to get in, and this is what allows to get the models out. However, it's a little complicated. This pad has two states, open and close. This pad is currently closed. However, if I press enter, this pad is open. However, if a model finishes, the open pad will not support it, and thus the model will go all over again. To remedy this, the teleporter closes the pad once a model hits it. Anyways, this is just a walk in the park. It gets harder from here. Remember when I said that it gets harder from here? Well, I lied. We're going to be making legs now. However, there are some things you need to know. First off, all your legs must be in a 16 by 16 box. You can build whatever you want in this box, but the models won't get outside of it, so be careful. Here are some legs I built. You can see they're all inside the box. Also, one thing that's really important. You can't have anything that moves in your scene. If the moving thing is anchored by an axle, that is fine. However, anything else is not allowed. Anyways, with that out of the way, we're now ready to go on to the final step. Unless you want to be some loser who drags their courses in. AKA me, but I had an editing, so... Take that! Anyways, you need a randomizer to get that authentic AMR6 experience. So let me find it. Wait, Jack Spero doesn't give out his code. Well, we're just left with one option now. Make it ourselves. You're gonna be writing some time to make this work. Let's get to it. So here's a really basic version of what we're gonna be making. We're going to make a clock where each number represents a leg. Legs have two states. They'll either be chosen or not. We're going to create two position variables for them. The position will move if the leg is chosen and move back when it isn't. Please note that axles will not move correctly. You're going to have to slip a glued object under it and then the axle for it to work. I'd like to thank the Marvelous Marbler for their solution. Now we got this working on this small box demo, let's scale it up. I really like this system as you can add more into it. Just add a new leg into the system and you're good. And to tie it all together, I made it so you can stop it. If you want to download this, check the description. Anyways, that's how you make Amazing Model Race Season 6. If you like this Algodoo video, subscribe for more. Want more model races? Click up here. I'll really appreciate it.